Hey everybody, Roy from ANS Gear, and we're gonna look at another BT gun today. This is the BT4 Combat Slice. Very, very basic gun. Not a lot of wow factors to this gun. It's gonna be just a workhorse. If you're looking for something that you can go shoot all the time, don't really have to worry about too much, you know it's gonna work, and be able to just be kind of beat up and still work, this is a great gun for you. The Slice flip-top lid concept makes it a little bit easier to work on, lets you get inside of the gun and access to a few of the internal parts without needing any tools, which is nice. So if you need to do cleaning, it does make it easy. So what you're gonna get in the box, you're gonna get the gun, you're gonna get the barrel, and you will also get Allen keys, basic manual, full manual on CD, and barrel sleeve. So pretty much standard fare for guns these days. Most everything you see, barrels or manuals are gonna be online or on a CD. If you lose the CD, you can always go to paintballsolutions.com and download it from them or look at it straight through their website. So the gun itself, super straightforward. A couple of the features that we see here, barrel, looks like a 8 or 9 inch ported barrel, A5 threaded. A lot of people are gonna switch that out unless they're just beginning, and this is gonna work great for a beginner. But with a different barrel, you could make your performance a little bit better accuracy. Foregrip on here, you can remove it if you don't like it and put something else on there. There is a rail system underneath, and you can mount anything you want to it, standard rail system. Steel braided line, you know it's going to be durable on there. Makes it a little hard to change things if you want to go to a different line setup or drop forward, something like that. But if you leave it as it is, it's going to run forever. Standard ASA. Charging handle on the top, pulls it back to cock. You do have your safety switch on the side. Pull the trigger to shoot the gun. Standard fare again. Velocity adjustment through the side here, screw it in clockwise to decrease, counterclockwise to increase velocity. There are upgrades for these. There is an electronic grip frame that you can put on there. So, I mean, if you were looking for a faster rate of fire, you can get that out of the gun rather than just being straight semi-automatic. Just make sure the loader that you're using can keep up with the electronics that you do decide to put on there. Feed neck. Clamping feed neck on there. It is offset, so if you put something along the top, it gives you a better chance of being just able to sight down the top of your gun. Plus, it is removable, so it's easy to clean should you get it dirty or get painted or get shot or whatever. Makes it very easy. Now, the whole concept behind the Slice guns is the flip-top ease of maintenance deal. So if we pop out this quick-release pin on the backside here, you should be able to lift the gun up and over and get inside of it. Now this is going to give us access to most of the parts, not everything on the inside there, because a couple pieces are still bolted into the gun. If we take our linkage arm out, we can take our barrel adapter out, we can take our bolt out, and that's really all we're going to be able to get to. The power tube, which you see right here, which has the valve inside of it, it is held in place by these two screws from the side right here. Plus, the steel braided line does thread up into it from the bottom. So you can't just pop out the power tube out of there. And then the hammer that you see back here, the spring and pin, guide pin for the spring run through the inside of it. So the best you could probably do with this is pull it back and then change this O-ring on it. If you want to remove it without taking the power tube out, the easiest way to do that would be to knock this pin. There's a roll pin that's right here that's knurled on one end. Knock it out, knurl side first. You could take the cap out, and then you could pull the guide pin, spring, and hammer out the back. Don't try to pull this thing back and like wedge it out through here or something like that. You'll probably just end up ruining it or damaging something, so don't try to do that. But other than that, it makes getting to most of the gun very, very simple. If you need to clean your bolt, get a ball break in there, something like that, it gives you that access, does make it easy. And again, putting it back together is very simple too. Put the bolt on, put our barrel adapter in there, get our linkage arm, slide it forward, lock it into place. Make sure that this guide pin on the top is standing straight up and down vertical. It does lock into the charging handle on the back there. If it's off center, it won't go in properly and it will not shut. So if you go to shut it and it doesn't just shut down like that, make sure your pin is lined up. It's probably what's causing it not to get in the way or not to lock down. Pop that through, And there you go. With the top off and you knock the pin out of the back, you could pull this plug out and put a stock on there, like a 98 custom stock. That style fitting should fit down in there, no problem. And there's lots of rails and accessories you can throw on there, but this gun is really geared towards people just getting into it. It's a great entry-level gun. It's gonna run forever. You don't need to do a lot of maintenance to them. It's a tried and true system. So check it out. If you're into this look or you're just getting started, maybe check out BG4 Combat Slice. Slice makes it easier to open. That's that whole flip top lid kind of thing. It's available through the website. Order yours now through ansgear.com.